Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. This week we're going to be painting our third owl painting. This is a double owl portrait, so we'll be painting two little cute owls here. Let's get started with our colors. We have titanium white, black, raw umber, burnt umber, raw sienna, yellow ochre, ultramarine blue, and a light pink. This is a Persian red. Any light pink will do though. Our paint brushes are going to be a medium to large flatter filbert, a smaller flatter filbert, this is a number 8, and then a kind of small flatter filbert, this is a number 2, and a liner or a round, a small round brush, and those are our paint brushes that we'll be using. So with our larger brush, our largest brush, we're going to put in this background, and it's going to be similar to the background we did last week, which is ultramarine blue and yellow ochre, and we're going to make it kind of green and a little bit of raw umber with that. So if you can see my mixture here, it's going to be a really dark green. And we're just going to cover the background with this. It looks brown, but it's green. I'm not sure if I'm going to do a second coat on this background. You definitely can if you don't like the way it looks. At the end, you can do a second coat of this color. I don't like to spend too much time fussing with the background. I want to spend most of my time getting the painting done and focusing on the painting. So I'm going to mix a little bit more of that. It was ultramarine blue, raw umber, and yellow ochre. I want it to be a really dark green. I just like to get as much of the white background or the white spaces of the painting covered as quickly as possible. Be careful around the edges of the owls. Piece of my brush is coming off, flaking off of the handle. just flaking out all over the place. Okay, so the background is done. We're going to let that dry. And like I said, at the end, if you want to go back over it again with the second coat, you can. I don't know if I'll have time to do it, but we'll give it a go. So you can rinse your brush out. And set that brush to the side, and we're going to go into our next largest brush, which is a filbert or a flat. And this was a number 8. I have a number 8. And we're going to start putting in the underpainting. So we're going to take some ultramarine blue, a little bit of raw umber. We definitely want it to be more blue than brown. But we want to darken it up a little bit. So we're going to come here and put this color in here. And I'm just tapping it in. There, and we have a little bit here. And if you have my pre-sketch canvas, you'll see where these lines are, where I'm putting this color in. Put a little bit here. Gonna mix a little bit more. Okay, miss some spots. Okay, have that in. I'm just looking around my reference filter to see where else we can put this color in. We're going to put it in here. And around here. And I see a little bit of it over here. Okay. And then over on this other bird, I see some more of this color over here. Okay. I'm going to add a little bit white, a little bit of white to that mixture that I already have on my palette there of the ultramarine blue and the raw umber. And I see that there's a little bit of blue, a little bit of a lighter blue up here. And around here. Okay. And you can rinse your brush out. Now we're going to go into our raw sienna, mixed with a little bit of burnt umber. Not too much. We still want it to be mostly raw sienna. And we're going to put that in up here. Again, we're just tapping this in. Then there's going to be some down here and along here. Okay. Let's see some over here. Bit here. There. There. I'm going to go over to the other little owl with that same mixture, burnt umber, raw umber, or raw sienna and burnt umber. Some here. Yeah. bit in here. Okay, now we're going to get some yellow ochre and add to that mixture, and a little bit of white to lighten it up a little bit. And we're going to go in here with that color. So we're going to put a little bit of that color on the other side. Just follow along with me. I'm just adding some of this lighter color in a couple of places. Okay. And you can rinse your brush out. Now we're going to go into our titanium white and raw umber. We're going to make a gray. We want it to be about there. Maybe a little bit of ultramarine blue just to cool it down a little bit. Okay. And we're going to put this here. And I'm just lightly tapping this in. Okay, gonna put a little bit of that color here. And I'm gonna put a little bit of that color up here. And around the eye. And around this, the beak. Okay. Put some of that color here. Bit of it right there. Okay. I think I want to go over this part with the gray. Okay, now with that same mixture, I want to add more white to make it even lighter. Ultramarine blue again. And we're going to go in here. Put it all in the wings. Just lightly. Going all the way around the face here. I know this is a lot of gray, but we gotta get some contrast colors in here because there's a lot of white on these owls. So I'm gonna mix a little bit more because I've run out. Now it's titanium white, a little bit of raw umber. A little smidge of ultramarine blue, a lot more white. A little bit more white for this part. Okay. And you can rinse your brush out. We're going to go back into our ultramarine blue and raw umber. It's going to be pretty dark. And we're going to put this in right here. Here. Okay. And we'll add a little bit more ultramarine blue to that mixture. And we'll tap this in over here. It's a little darker than I wanted it to be, but that's okay. Also, while we have this color, we're gonna put it in here, in this eye. And let's see where else we can put it. Just putting in this darker color here. Okay, you can rinse off your brush. We almost have the whole underpainting done now. Okay, so with our number 8 or our medium or smaller, flat around, we are going to get some of our raw sienna and a little bit of burnt umber. So that's raw sienna, a little bit of burnt umber. And we're going to go and we'll put this in here. And then we're also going to put it in here. Okay, put a little bit more over here. Since we have it on our brushes already. Okay, then we'll rinse that out. Dry off our brush, and then we'll go to our smallest flat. This is a number 2. And we're going to, I think we'll get some ultramarine blue, a little bit of raw umber, and some white. So it's going to be like a grayish bluish color, maybe a little bit more raw umber. We want to darken it up a little bit more. Yeah, that looks about right. And this is going to go right around the eye here. And we're going to get it in around here and here. Okay. And we're going to put it in around here and there. And we're also going to put some of this color in here. Just follow along with what I'm doing. Put some of that right there. And down here. Okay. Gonna put some of that over here. Just scrubbing it in, this lighter blue color. We're not covering up all of that darker color that we had in there. We're just scrubbing a little bit over it. You can rinse your brush out. And we're going to go into our raw umber and just a tad bit of white. Just to gray it up a little bit, but it's going to be a kind of a dark gray. And that you'll see these lines for the wings here on the pre-sketch canvas. And we're just going to follow those lines. Try not to let it be too thick like I did mine just now. You can use a round brush, your small round brush for this if you want. Okay. And I'm going to add a little bit of pink to that color and see what that does. Maybe a little bit of blue, ultramarine blue. A little bit more pink. This is like a pinkish gray color. I'm going to put that in here. And I'm also going to put that here. Okay. Okay, you can rinse your brush out. There are these little spots on the wings. We're going to use just some black. We're still using the smallest flat brush you have. We're just going to fill in those little dark spots. I had too much water on my brush, so I'm going to kind of pick that up. Kind of erase that off. Dry my brush off a little bit more and go back into my black. And I'm going to kind of fill in those dark spots on the wings here. Just so I won't forget where they are, because we've covered it up quite a bit. And they're kind of like in these little heart shapes almost. Rinse a brush out. If you have any more of that pink gray mixture, put that back on your brush, and we're gonna put this in here. And we'll go over that. We're going to add some white to that, if you have any of that left on there, and lighten it up. Don't press too hard here. We're just putting a little hint of that color there. Okay. And we're going to go on this side. Dab that in there. Okay. And you can rinse your brush out. We're going to take some of our raw sienna, mix it with some white to lighten it up. And go right here. Put that in there. Just wherever you see me putting this color in, follow along. Okay, and we'll move over here. I'm just dabbing this in here. Just mix some more of that. That was the raw sienna and white. I'm just going to go over some of this blue a little bit. My brush is really dry. There's not a lot of water on it. Now we're going to go into our yellow ochre and a little bit of white. I got a darker color mixed in with there on accident, but that's okay. Now I'm gonna cover some of these with this. And I know that I did some of these already, and I'm just covering up some of the stuff that I already did, but I like to have those colors in the background. They definitely can shine through. So I like to have them in there. Put a little bit of this color over here. Put a little bit of this color right here. And I'm just lightly scrubbing some of this yellow gold color in the wings. We will go back over that with a little bit of white, but I want to have that little bit of gold color peeking through. Okay. We're going to go into our burnt umber. We're going to put that in over here. And we're also going to put it in around here. And that's just straight burnt umber. There's no mixture. And put that in around here. And I'm just tapping this along this perimeter of the face. It's not a straight line or anything. Okay, and you can rinse your brush out. It's looking good, guys. Let's go back to the background for a second before I forget to do a second coat. I always forget that. So we're going to go into our ultramarine blue, our yellow ochre, and a little bit of raw umber. We want it to be dark, but not as dark as it was the first time. And we'll get a little bit of titanium white. I want a little bit of yellow ochre, a little bit more, make it more green. If you like the darker green better, you could leave it like that. Or if you want it darker, you can add a more ultramarine blue or more raw umber to make it darker. And I'm just putting this all over. I'm going to add a little bit more yellow ochre to that. And a little bit more ultramarine blue. I'm just dabbing it in random places. Just lightly putting it in random places. A little bit more ultramarine blue. Okay, so we have the background situated. And you can rinse out your brush. And we're going to get our medium or 8 size flat or filbert. Let's find a clean space on my palette here, and I'm going to mix that with a lot of white where you can barely see the blue. And I'm going to go around here and dab this in. I'm not going to completely cover the gray, but I'm just dabbing it in. Might want a little bit more white. It's too blue. And just follow along with what I'm doing here. Just softly scrubbing this in. I go in here. Careful not to erase those black little dots that we have in there. I'm kind of going around them. Okay. just dabbing this in. Gonna mix some more of that color. So it was titanium white, a little bit of ultramarine blue. Just enough blue that it's not completely white. Dabbing that around here. And keep your brush pretty dry. I don't want any water in here in this on your brush right now. Okay. And now with just white, we're going to go back over these a little bit more. We're not completely covering up that light blue. This is just white now. Follow along with what I'm doing. My paint is pretty thick because I don't have any water or any mixture in this white. Okay. Now we're going to, whatever white you have left on your brush, we're going to mix that with yellow ochre. Want it to be pretty light. And a little bit of burnt umber I'm going to put right here. Raw sienna. Put some of that back in here. Okay. You can rinse your brush out. This area here is looking a little too bright to me, so I'm going to mix some more ultramarine blue and raw umber. Again, it's going to be more blue than brown and a little bit of white. And I'm just going to dab it in here just randomly. This was looking a little too yellow. Okay. See if we can put that color anywhere else. Okay, we're gonna add a lot more white to that mixture, whatever is on your brush, some white. I'm gonna put that over this eye. And we're going to put a little bit of that over here. Put a little bit right here. You can rinse your brush out. And these barn owls have like these little dots all over. So we're going to go into our black. And they have all these little spots like randomly in here. And I have my small round. And I'm just dabbing it in wherever I see those little dots. There's like a million of them. And that's just straight black. There's no mixture. They got some over here. There's lots of them over here. Just random little dots. Put that eye back in. Just random little spots. They have some over here. Just random little spots. And then some down here. Okay, rinse your brush out. Then over on here, there's lots of little white spots. So we'll put those in. There, and then along this wing here. And some up here. Okay. Let's put a little white on this eye here. We'll do a little bit here. We'll also do this on this eye. Put a little white here, a little white there. Then we'll put in a little white over here. Just dabbing it in. Okay. And a little white here. And that is about it, you guys. So this painting is done. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below. And I will see you in my next video. Bye.